God's mercy kept me. Can I get a witness in here? So
I
wouldn't let
go. I welcome you specially to this wonderful episode, and I'm too sure, I'm resolute, that by the grace of God, by the reason of the information that would come to you today, you will understand the dynamics of life. You know, sometimes life may not be fair. And that's why I tell people, when life hits you, don't head it. It's madness. Don't chest it. It's high blood pressure. You can walk over it. It takes understanding to walk over pressure. It takes understanding to be outstanding. Help only come when you have understanding of the one that is the help of the helpless, the only present help in the time of trouble. A man may be present, he may not be helpful. A man may be helpful, he may not be present. He's the only one that is the present help in the time of need. My name is Olufunke Adetuberu. This is Take Your Life Back. Life is so precious. Like I said, you have only one life to live. It's your life. It's all about your life. Listen to me. Nobody lives your life for you. You live your life by yourself. I've seen people. Do you know that even in the natural, until you have a child, it's not your own. You have to push, you have to labor, you have to carry the baby for 9 months. Then they will say, this is my own child. That is how life is. Until you give birth, you push, you groan, you travail, you give birth, it's not your own. It is so important for you to take your life back. Life is too precious for you to squander it and waste it. I've seen people that have squandered their lives, they have wasted their lives on the altar of sex, on the altar of pornography, on the altar of masturbation, on the altar of extramarital relationship. And before you know it today, they are nowhere to be found. They have labored, you know, whatever it is that you are going through, if you don't deal with it, it's going to deal with you back. Any sin, anything you don't deal with is dealing with you. And when it begins to deal with you, you'll be so shocked. And you are wondering, you know, I've seen a lot of people that will sit and say, how did I get here? What really happened? What's the problem? Why am I like this? How did I end there? Yes, something happened in the journey of your life and you refuse to wake up and take your life back. Please, don't hesitate. There's no price that is too high to pay to have your life back. There's no price that is too high for you to take your life back. You must pay the price, and paying the price, your life is your own. Until you give birth to it, nobody calls it your own. It's not your own. You must have it to become your own. That is why you say, my child, my certificate. You labored for it. You worked for it. My car, you got it. My house, you built it. That is how life is. Until you take it by the horn, it's like taking the bull by the horn. Until you take your life the way it is, nobody values it. Nobody appreciates it. Nothing happens. At the end of the day, you are just on your own. Once again, I welcome you to this wonderful episode on this amazing station, PRZFM, in the city of London. I'm so passionate about what I say. I'm so passionate about what I understand, especially in the dynamics of life. If you don't take your life back, nobody will take it for you. You know, even Jesus said, I lay it down by myself. Nobody forced me. And because he did by himself, he could have all of us. He died for us and he had all of us. If he had said, no, I'm not going to drop my life. I'm not going to live my life for anyone. I'm not going to die for anybody. At the end of the day, we won't have all of us coming to the Lord Jesus today. So listen to me. Your life is your own. I need to bring out a point today. And that point is the dynamics of denial. Because of what we have been through in life, we can believe in so much lies. I will start living in that lie as if it's the truth. Most of the conferences I go to preach, I ask a very simple question. How many of us have told a lie to yourself and you have so much believed in that lies? You have lived in that lie. You have been so comfortable with that lies. And honestly, you don't even know that you are lying again. Because you can lie to yourself and the lie will now become the truth. And you'll be living in the light of the lie that you have told yourself. And that is what we call denial. As far as I'm concerned, denial is demonic. Denial is an attack of the enemy over anybody's destiny. If you cannot trace it, if you keep living in denial, you cannot trace it, you don't come to yourself and come to your senses and say, excuse me, what I am doing, what is going to be the end? How is it going to end? Am I going to end my journey halfway? Am I going to live my life like this? Am I going to permanently, perpetually remain in lies and denials? I have to do something about it. You know, I told you about the case of the prodigal son in some of the episodes. If you have missed any episodes, you can go to our iCloud and get it back and listen again and again. It's so amazing. So amazing. For that young man to go on a riotous living, deny the fact that he was losing money, but suddenly it dawned on him, let me go back. I'll go back home. Whatever happens, if I'm going to be a slave, if I'm going to be welcome, whatever it is, I'm coming back home. Until denial stops, nothing changes. But do you know something? Denial is very sweet. It suits your feelings of inadequacies. It makes you comfortable. It makes you feel at ease. For instance, somebody that is going through pain, and the next thing is you get a bottle of alcohol, or you get into drugs, or you get into nicotine, or you're addicted to caffeine. You just take something that will keep you cool, or you get into serious masturbation. It gives you a little bit of relief, but you know that that relief is temporal. You still have to go back to it. You keep going in the circle of the same thing. It's like going round and round and round, merry-go-rounding and getting stuck. If you are like that and you are listening to me, you are living in denial. You have taken so much alcohol. You have taken so much nicotine. You are so much on drugs. You've taken so much caffeine. You put yourself, your brain into, you put so much pressure on your brain to an extent that the only way you can get it out and let out your steam, let out your pressure, let out the things that is happening in your life that you don't like, is to engage your brain in an addictive circle. The moment you are in that circle, one thing happens to you. You sit in a place of denial. You pretend as if everything is fine, but you know it's not fine. Once in a while, something tells you, how do I stop? What do I do? Who will help us? Who will help me? You know that for sure. If you are in that, if you are drenched in that, this is an opportunity for you. You can send me a text on +234 80 232 42389 or +234 90 35 81 48 92. I'll say them again. +234 80 232 42389 +234 90 20 10 80 +234 90 20 10 80 or follow me on my Instagram page, Funke Adetuberu. My Facebook page is Olufunke Adetuberu or She Matters Olufunke. My Twitter handle is Adetuberu Abimbola. Your life is so important. Please take it back. If you are thinking of coming out of where you are, you know you are tired, you need help, you want to start another life, you want to get into a level of rest in your mental, emotional, physical, and psychological life, welcome on board. Please make sure you get across to me. I'm saying something about denial. Denial makes you comfortable, makes you relaxed. You've lived in lies a lot, but you can stop it. Denial is when you make a decision by feeding that part of your life that is not good, that is making you unhappy, that is making you sad, feeding that part of your life with a lot of lies so that you can be a little bit comfortable. I've seen somebody that steals and say, I don't steal. I'm not stealing. It's because I have a need. In denial, you rationalize. I've seen women sleeping with another man that is not their husband. I've seen men sleeping with another woman that is not their wives. And what they tell themselves is that my wife is pregnant, one. My wife is old. She's no more beautiful. She's now dirty. She's adding weight. I want somebody that is slim. And she's denying me sex. She's refusing me to touch her. And because of that, I need to act out. Excuse me, you are living in denial. You are lying to yourself. Listen to me, there's no reason for infidelity. There is no reason for it. If your wife or your husband is not meeting your emotional needs, you are not supposed to look for it somewhere else. You have a dialogue. You get a professional help. You send an email. You call. You seek help. I used to say that it's only in the kingdom of God that we don't respect professionals. By the grace of God, I'm almost 60. I use glasses. I have my optician. I had to fill my teeth because of chocolate. I had to see my dentist. When I turned 50, I began to have pain on my knees because of arthritis. I had to see my doctor. I was medically advised and I was given medication. Today, I'm fine. What about you and I that have all the parts in the body and we don't respect that? Some have been given grace to handle issues like addiction, family crisis. God is too intelligent to be disorganized. God is dynamic. He has a way of helping people to make... The Bible says he has given us all things that pertain to life, this life and godliness. Everything. Everything that has to do with this life and godliness. He has given us everything that pertains to life. So there's nothing missing, nothing to lose. But if you now keep giving yourself unnecessary alibi, your excuses are, my wife is not there. Some are even prostituting now and say, my parents, they don't pay my school fees. So whatever I have to do, I have to do it. You're just lying to yourself. Oh, I have to get into drugs. I feel comfortable when I smoke hemp, when I smoke marijuana. I'm very comfortable when I go into pornography, when I go into masturbation. Excuse me. It's an alibi. You are in denial. And listen to me. Until denial stops, nothing changes. My name is Olufunke Adetuberu. Thank you for listening to me. I'll be right back after this music break.
God's mercy kept me.
God's mercy.
Can I get a witness in here that knows about God's grace?
Welcome back to this wonderful episode of Take Your Life Back on this amazing radio station. Please tell your friends. You can share it. You can actually get on our iCloud and tell your friends. Because listen, understanding makes you to stand. Understanding makes you to be outstanding. Ignorance is not an excuse. If you jump from a 25-story building and you come back and tell your friends, oh, I don't know. It's not you that will tell your friends. It's the news, CNN. They have to do a broadcast on someone who is not smart enough to understand that what goes up must come down. So if whatever it is that you are believing and is in your belief system that is making you to live a life that is not even appealing to you, you are not happy about it, please, you can take your life back. I was saying something about denial. Denial is a way you numb your pain. Because you know that at least if I say this is not there, nothing is happening to me, I'm fine. You are keeping the pain underneath. You are subsiding the pain. But in fairness, the pain is not subsided. Have you seen someone that is drunk and say, well, when I get drunk, I'm this thinking, this emotional baggages, this anger, this thing that is happening to my family, this my wife that is misbehaving, this my husband that is acting out. When I get drunk, when I get high, I'm going to be fine. Honestly, after the alcohol frizzles out, you pick your pain where you have left it. And that is the pain of denial. That is the hazard of living in denial. Denial helps you to cover up. Can I quickly ask some questions this moment? Can you just take a pen and a paper and write the things that is happening to you that you are not happy about, but you have denied it? You just said it's not there, but you know it's obviously there. Recently, let me share this story with you. I heard a lady cry and shout in my neighborhood, and the baby too was crying, and I'm hearing the husband, I'll kill you, I'll beat you, and I was hearing the husband hitting her mercilessly. And I went there, it was around 11 p.m., I didn't have a choice than to just go to that house because I don't want somebody to die in the neighborhood. And, you know, I would also be in denial or saying that I did not hear the noise and all of that. So I went. I knocked the door. It took them time to open the door of their house. And when the door was opened, I came in to see the two of them. And guess what? I asked the wife, what have we said? Nothing. Is your husband beating you? He said, no. Hey! I said, what is this? That is the height of denial. You are listening to me now. You are in an abusive relationship. Somebody is beating you hollow. You are hearing me. There are some that they are in a relationship. It is only outside that the man is good to you. The woman is good to you. You are wearing a mask. It's just a facade. It's an open lies. Everything, it looks good on the outside. But the moment you step into the door of your house, you are in hell. And you are telling everybody nothing is wrong. You are telling everybody you are fine. You are telling your mates that everything is in order. You are telling your colleague in the office that, you know, I'm fine. I have the best marriage. Everything is rosy. Excuse me. Please, can I say this over and over again? Until denial stops, nothing changes. If you don't wake up to take your life back, some have been killed by a violent husband. Some have been poisoned by an abusive wife right in the same home, because somebody is living in lies. Somebody is living in denial. Somebody is refusing the truth. The truth that has the ability and the capacity to set free. Somebody is telling himself or herself, everything is fine. Now, don't get me wrong. I'm not saying that you should go and be telling your stories to someone that cannot help you. You don't cry before someone that will not say sorry to you, but you still need to cry out. Maybe you are hearing me now. Somebody is molesting you. Your mommy's boyfriend is trying to molest you sexually or harass you sexually. Or someone is somewhere somehow messing up your life and messing up your mind. Excuse me, cry out. Don't keep quiet. Stop lying to yourself. Don't cover it up. I've shared it in one of the episodes, probably somewhere or somewhere else, that whatever you cover will decay. I think I made an example of my toenails, that the guy that was doing my pedicure said, mommy, can we just clean these toes? The nail is stinking, is rotten, is infected. I said, excuse me, can you just polish it and clean it and leave it like that? And the guy will say, okay, ma, you know, it's your leg, it's your life. If you don't take your life back, it's still your life. If you keep living in denial, it's still your life. If you keep lying to yourself, it's still your life. If you are in pain and you are telling the world you are fine, it's still your life. But it's a matter of time. It's all about your life. It has nothing to do with anybody's life. So I remember that day I was on my feet. I was ministering. I was preaching. And suddenly the nail fell off. And blood was everywhere on the floor. I don't know how we managed to clean the place. My nail was on the floor. And the Holy Spirit said to me, anything you cover will decay. Anything you manage will be messed up or spoil at the end of the day. You manage your health, if you manage your home, you manage your car, whatever it is, anything you manage is going to get spoiled at the end of the day. It's better to face it. Trace it. Stop deceiving yourself. Don't lie to yourself. Do you know it was possible for the prodigal son to tell himself, nothing is happening here. Everything is fine. I'll be okay. It's not a big deal. I'll be fine. Let me keep eating with the pigs. There is no way he would have gone back home to get that kind of joy and celebration that happened after his coming back home. You can make a decision to pull yourself together, to come back and tell yourself, enough of lying about what is happening in my life. I will not lie about what I'm going through. I will make it open. I will not cover it because I don't want it to decay. Some people lie that their father is a governor, is a president, is a mayor, and their dad is just nobody because of the kind of shame that is involved. In the next episode, I'll be talking about shame. The only thing that is not redeemable is death. Shame is redeemable. You cannot afford to keep being in denial of what is such a reality. I've seen people that will come home drunk, and everybody say, you are drunk. I say, no, I'm not drunk. And the man prostrated there to greet everybody, and he sleeps there, or he vomits everywhere, and he's still saying, I'm not drunk. Who told you I'm drunk? And he's stenching. Every part of his body is smelling alcohol. And he's saying, there's no problem. Until that person wakes up. Until you wake up. Until you tell yourself, I'm going back. I will take my life back. I'm fed up. I'm tired. I cannot continue to live my life like this. There was a story in the scriptures, Esau and Jacob. It took him a heart that is determined and resolute to take his life back. You know, he sold his birthright. And his brother, of course, he told his brother, he was so flippant with life. You can't be careless with life. He told his brother, give me my pottage. I want to eat. What is in my birthright? And he took it. He exchanged it with pottage. And that was it. But he went to his dad. And his brother took his birthright. You know everything. He took it the day he was careless with his life was the day his birthright was taken. The rest was just the manifestation of other things. So when his brother took his, you know, the blessing from his dad, and went to his dad, he said, Dad, just one more. Give me one, please. The Bible says he sought it with tears. He could not get it. But you know what happened? His father made a statement that I want to leave you with today. He said, if you cannot take it anymore, you will break through. That is, if you stop being in denial, rapture is your limit, sky is your starting point. If you can tell yourself, enough, we are moving into the new year, you can't continue like this. Please don't hesitate. Send me a text on +234 80232 423 89, or send me an email on cryonmenow@gmail.com or at yahoo.com. cryonmenow@gmail.com, cryonmenow@yahoo.com. Please send me a text +234 90 20 10 10 80. Don't hesitate. Life is too short to be careless with life. Life is too short to be careless with life. I want to say a very big thank you for listening to me. My name is Olufunke Adetuberu. I wish you a compliment of this amazing season. The reason for Christmas is for you to appreciate the fact that somebody came to this life to help you and he died for you. So he doesn't want you to live in lies. He wants you to take your life back. Thank you so much for listening. I'll see you next week.
Somebody next to him. I was really.